introverted, can't make friends. Pray for better days. Now it's 300K when my day ends. Do you
Good morning, Chargers.
It's Daisy
and Nikita. Welcome back to WRSN.
Today's show includes updates on upcoming clubs and events.
Let's get right into it.
Before we get into today's club meetings, let's hear a recap of this weekend's debate tournament. Today here at Suncoast, the debate team competed on November 6th at Park Vista High School and won in various events. Justin Ricketts was first in original oratory, and congressional debate, Sophia Osborne was first. Abdulaziz Kunfar was second and best presiding officer. Tanmay Mahani was second and best presiding officer. Emily Cuba was placed third, John Wager was sixth and best presiding officer, and Zara Alam was best presiding officer. Miguel Herrera and Rachel Yulvidal placed fourth in duo interpretation. Anila Williams placed first in oral interpretation, and Rebecca Barris placed second in dramatic performance. Keep up the good work and congratulations, Chargers.
Speaking of dramatic performances, let's go to Alina to learn more about Suncoast Theater upcoming play, Almost Maine.
With all the changes in school post-COVID, including our old chorus and theater director Mrs. Nixdorf leaving, 2021 could have been the year Suncoast almost found itself without a theater director. However, despite not having an established theater teacher, Suncoast Theater will continue to shine under the direction of our new director, Mr. Mandini.
I decided to come to Suncoast because the opportunity was presented to me by my former principal at Bach Middle School of the Arts. I was the musical theater teacher over there and recently left to pursue coaching and directing outside of the public school setting. But when this opportunity came about, I was really excited to be able to come to a high school level to be able to explore directing with students in a program that wasn't so focused on theater, but had the experience and desire for it.
Coming from Bach Middle, a magnet school for the arts, he has high expectations for Suncoast.
My expectations for Suncoast Theater as a whole are, one, to have fun. I want students to be able to have an outlet to play and enjoy themselves in an art form that kind of gives them relief from their day-to-day stresses of academics, which I know are really paramount here at Suncoast. But on top of that, I want to produce really good, interesting shows that give everyone an opportunity to see theater in a different light.
With Suncoast not having had any theater performances since November of 2019, December 3rd and 4th will change that, as they will be presenting John Cariani's Almost Maine.
I chose this show in particular because it is a vignette show. So that means that there are 9 individual short plays that could accommodate a large cast and be rehearsed pretty quickly because we have such a short rehearsal period. So I'm really looking forward to it, and it's a really heartwarming show that explores the idea of love and losing love.
Drayton Wilkins, who plays 2 roles in this show, also has a few goals in mind.
I'm looking forward to see how much I improved from my personal projects, and that was what my project was to get better at acting. So I want to see how much I improved and how would I have to work on. I look forward to getting to be a bit more experienced, see what else we can do this school year, despite, you know, all the regulations.
The cast and crew of Almost Maine is hard at work, with rehearsals in full swing as well as tech. So be sure to start marking your calendars for December 3rd and 4th, as this is one show you won't want to miss. Reporting for WRSN, this has been Alina.
On a different note, Suncoast Amnesty International is hosting a variety of different letter-writing meetings this week. Take part in a global letter-writing campaign and the world's largest human rights event. The campaign supports people who have been harassed, threatened, and unjustly jailed. Write letters defending victims of human rights violations, enjoy snacks, and earn VPS, CAS, or NHS hours. Hope to see you there.
Another place to express your opinions is the Political Discourse Club. If you're interested in sharing your political opinions in a civil and relaxed environment, or want to hear about different perspectives to share your own, join the Political Discourse Club. The information meeting is in room 307. During lunch, join the Google Classroom and the Discord using the codes on screen.
Another club concerned about uplifting others is the Kindness Matters 365 Club. Attend their meeting today during lunch in the chorus room for a positive affirmation activity. Learn ways to self-navigate, build up confidence in yourself, and gain CAS or VPS hours.
Just like Kindness Matters 365 supports our students, Hands Across Campus aims to support the diverse culture here at Suncoast. This month, they are celebrating Native American heritage. Join them today during lunch in the atrium and courtyard to make traditional Native American crafts to celebrate Native American Heritage Month. CAS hours are available. See you there, Chargers.
That's all for the club's meeting today. Now let's toss it over to Hudson for all of our sports updates.
Senior night, a time where excitement and nostalgia were running high. As the class of 2022 played their last home game, the football and cheerleading teams lit the field with their passion and left their own blazing trails characteristic of the Suncoast Chargers.
So I was really excited for senior night because I've been on the cheer team for 4 years and I just love these girls, so I was really excited to be able to spend it with them.
The field left many moments for the seniors.
For lots of memory. And I know that's probably going to be a sad night as well because I might shed some tears at the end of the game, knowing that getting that feeling. So I just want to help my brothers out.
For me being a senior, I'm going to be sad that this is our last game. And I just want my players, brothers before me to do the best they can as I can after I graduate so that way they can keep the tradition going.
Congratulations to both the football and cheerleading teams on an amazing senior night. This has been Kimmy
and Samaya reporting for WRSN.
The varsity girls volleyball team traveled to Merritt Island High School to compete in the Region 4 semifinal regional match on Wednesday, November 3rd. After going head-to-head in a total of 4 sets, the Chargers unfortunately came out with a close loss to Merritt Island and have concluded their season with a total of 18 wins and 9 losses. Head coach Christian Spence shares his expressions for the match.
I've prepared my team all week for this match, and I am very excited to be here and see what my Lady Chargers do tonight.
After last week's 3-set sweep against Terra Environmental in Kendall, the Chargers have tirelessly practiced and prepared for this match.
We're excited. We've worked hard these past couple of weeks.
The Chargers kept the match close in the first 2 sets by keeping difference in the single digits. The Chargers took the lead in the 3rd set with a score of 25-18, and the last set was a tough fight with a score of 19-25, resulting in the Chargers' loss of 1-3 total sets. Congratulations to seniors Zoe Zaloga, Alex Sapia, Kate Hanna, Mackenzie Grizzard, and Palmer Allen on their amazing season. This has been Daisy reporting for WRSN. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Hudson. All this talk about sports is making me hungry. Let's send it over to Sam for the latest on lunch.
How's it going, Hungry Chargers? I'm Sam, here to fill you in on the food that'll fill you up for lunch today. First up, we've got cheese pizza crunchers, followed by hot dogs, spicy chicken tenders, and an Italian sub combo. After that, we've got the usual chocolate chip muffin platter, great PB&J or soy butter sandwich platter, and a California blend. That sure sounds good. Now good luck making it to the lunch line fast enough to get that food and have a chance to eat it. This has been the latest on lunch, and I've been Sam, signing off.
Thanks, Sam. There may not be any birthday cake on the menu, but we still want to wish a very happy birthday to all our Chargers today.
Before we wrap up, we want to remind you to check our accompanying slides for more information about today's announcements and extra details that we couldn't fit into the show. That's all for today, Chargers. This has been Daisy
and Nikita with WRSN. Thanks for tuning in. Be careful with our heart, 'cause it's fragile. And thinking about our past make a lash out.